गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, आई एम गोइंग टू टेक साइंस फॉर यू. सो आई हैव गॉट साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक नाउ. प्लीज ओपन दैट वन एंड ओपन पेज नंबर 35. इन द लास्ट क्लास आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट अवर फेदर्ड फ्रेंड्स. सो द बर्ड विल फ्लाई लाइक अ क्रिएचर एंड इट हैज टू स्ट्रॉन्ग विंग्स एंड लेग्स एंड इट कैन फ्लाई इन द स्काई एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ फेदर्स. सो हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ फेदर्स आर देयर? There are 6 types of feathers. In that, I explain only 4 types of feathers. So, that are first one flight feathers, second one counter feathers, third one down feathers, fourth one semi-plume feathers. So, I explain that 4 feathers. Now, I am going to explain 5th and 6th types of feathers. So, I'll read, listen carefully. Bristle feathers. Bristle feathers are very stiff with only a few barbs found at the base. Bristle feathers are found around the mouth of the insect eating birds where they act as a funnel. They can also be found around the eyes where they work like eyelashes. So these bristle feathers are very stiff and it is found only at the barbs base. And these bristle feathers are found around the mouth. That insect bird, it'll eat birds, will eat insects, no? And it is found there and they act as a funnel and it can be also found around the eyes and it will work like a eyelashes. Next, 6th, phylloplume feathers. So, phylloplume feathers are incredibly small. They have a tuft of barbs at the end of the shaft. Unlike other feathers which are attached to the muscles for movement, phylloplume feathers are attached to the nerve endings. These feathers send messages to the brain that give information about the placement of feathers for light, insulation and preening. See this phylloplume feathers. It is very small and it is where they have tuft and in the end they have shaft. So other feathers, it is attached to the muscles for movement and these feathers are attached to the nerve endings and these feathers help to send the messages to the brain and to get information for the placement of feathers or for flight, means going here and there in the sky. Next is types of beak. All bird species have a beak adapted for acquiring, handling and consuming their particular food. Numerous types of beaks are seen, but the majority of birds may be classified as having one of 6 main styles. So, you have seen the bird, no children? So, it has a beak. No? It is helpful to eat the food. No children? So many types of beaks are there. But majority of birds, it is classified into 6 main types. So, the 6 main types are, first one, small, hard and pointed beak. So, it has a small and it has a pointed beak. See in the picture they are given. For example, sparrow, pigeons, peacocks and finches eat seeds and grains. They can break their food by their beaks into small pieces. So, these all birds, sparrow, pigeon, peacocks, it eats seeds and grain, no? That beak will help to break the food by their beaks into small pieces. These beaks will help to break into small pieces. Next, hooked beak. Parrots are characterized by the short, curved beaks. It enables them to crack seeds and nuts and assist them in gripping barks and branches while climbing as well. See, in the picture they are given parrot and it has a short curved beak. That beak is like a curved. It helps to eat, crack the seeds and nuts and it helps to gripping the branches also for climbing. Next, third one. Strong, sharp and hooked beak. So, eagles, vultures, kites and owls have strong, sharp and hooked beak. They tear their flesh into small pieces. So this eagle, vultures, kites and owls, these all birds have strong and sharp and hooked beaks. So these beaks help there to tear the flesh and cut into small pieces. Next, fourth one, short and broad beak. The swallow has a broad and short beak. They catch tiny flying insects and flies which stick inside their mouth while flying. See in the picture, this bird name is swallow and it has a broad and short beak. So this beak help to catch tiny, means small insects and flies also. So which stick inside their mouth while flying. Okay children, so these are the four types of beak. Next, fifth type, long and slender beak. The whoopee has a long and slender beak. They use their beak to pull out insects from holes in the ground. See, they are given here the picture. This bird is called whoopee bird and it has a long and slender beak and it uses its beak to pull out insects from the holes in the ground. Next, sixth one, broad, long and pointed beak. Kingfishers and storks have broad, long and pointed beaks. They catch fish from rivers and ponds for its food. So in the picture, this picture bird name is kingfisher and stork. So it has a broad and long and pointed beaks. So this beak help them to catch fish and from the rivers and ponds for its food. It helps it, that beak helps it to catch fish from the rivers, ponds and eat it as a food. Okay children, next is types of foot. So you have seen in the bird down, it that foots help it to walk, fly and all. Okay children, see in this picture there are so many types of foots. Two types of foot is there. 2, 3, 4, 5 types is there. Birds use their claws to catch food and to protect themselves. They use them to sit on branches. Their feet and claws are suited for these functions. The feet and legs are covered with scales. Birds have 2 to 4 toes on each foot. Claws on the feet are used for grasping the prey, for perching, for scratching the ground or for fighting. See in the picture, the given types of foot. So it helps to catch the food and to protect themselves, and they use to sit on the branches. So they have feet and the legs, it is covered with scales. Some birds have 2 to 4 toes. We have 5 toes, no, on our, 5 toes on our legs, no. So these birds have 2 to 4 foot. So these feet are used for grasping, for catching the prey and scratching the ground and for fighting also. So first type of foot is wading foot. The long legs of killdeer makes it possible for them to wade into ponds and streams to catch and eat small water animals. So in this picture they are given, no, like black color, that is called wading foot, and it helps to in the pond and stream to catch and eat small water animals like fish, insects and all. Next, second one, swimming foot. Ducks and loons have webbed feet which they use to paddle through water. So you have seen ducks, no children, so it has a webbed feet. So it helps to swim in the water and catch the insects. Next, an ostrich is the largest bird and the heaviest living bird. It can't fly but it can run at the speed of 70 km per hour. So ostrich is the largest bird and it is the heaviest bird, but it can't fly but it can run so fast, 70 km per hour. Next, third is climbing foot. Woodpeckers have sharp curved claws that help them to climb and to clutch the bark of trees. 2 toes point forward and 2 point backward. See, this woodpecker इट हैज ए शॉर्ट कर्व्ड क्लॉज एंड इट हेल्प्स इट टू क्लाइंब द बार्क ऑफ द ट्रीज. सो टू टोज विल बी फ्रंट एंड अदर टू टोज विल बी बैक साइड. नेक्स्ट पर्चिंग फुट. All song birds or perching birds have three toes pointing forward and one pointing backward. Such birds clamp their toes around a branch to keep from falling off. So singing birds or perching bird means they'll be moving around there, no? So that are three toes, front, forward. In the front side, three toes will be there, and in the back side, only one will be there. So these toes have branch to keep, it helps to falling off. Student, next. Fifth type of foot, grasping foot. Hawks and owls have sharp curved claws or talons with which they catch their prey. They use their strong claws to crush their victims and to carry them away. See, in this picture, these claws are very sharp. Now children, it has curved claws and they use to catch the prey, and it is used to crush the animals, insects, and they can help to carry them away. Children, next, fact finder. Homing pigeons are bred to find their way home from long distance away and have been used for thousands of years to carry messages. So next is nest. Nest means gudu. Birds are very choosy and prefer to nest in a specific way. This is evolutionary and developed over many thousands of years. The main purpose is to find a safe place for the bird to lay eggs, incubate and raise their brood in relative safety. First is adherent. These are very messy but very impressive nests, often made of mud and built against a surface like a tree, wall or cliff. They come in a range of sizes and shapes. Some are conical and some are round and V-shaped depending on the bird type. The nest is often built over time using mud or dirt added in layers and right between application to form a nice shape. So this nest are built with mud and surface of a tree or wall, and its size and shapes are conical and sometimes round and sometimes V-shaped. Next is burrow. Some birds find comfort in nesting underground. They use their beaks to burrow deep down into cliff or ground. They can build a chamber of the tunnel to create a safe place to raise their brood. Next is burrow. So these birds find comfort in nesting underground the tree. They use their beaks to keep down cliff or ground. Next is cavity. These are nests inside the trees. Many species choose a cavity that rely on their spices or nature to create the cavity from them. Being in out of their habitat, they are able to raise their brood easily. Bird box or nest box mimic the cavity. So this cavity is inside the trees and it helps the bird boxes or nest box to mimic the cavity. Okay children, next. Cup. These are often made by birds who make nests from grasses, twigs and mud. They are often seated in the V of a tree, allowing the bird to feel safe and secure. See, in this picture, they build a nest. It is built by grasses, twigs and mud. They build their nest to keep safe and secure. Next, fifth one, pendant. These are, like the name implies, a swinging, hanging nest. So it will be hanging on the tree. The nest is a cup. So it is like a cup. This nest is like a cup, spherical or a sack, and is often woven from fine grasses. So this nest are built with grasses. The birds often spend hours building the nest and can turn into works of art. So, to build this nest, the birds spend so many hours and it turn the work of the art. Okay, children? Next, fact finder. Hummingbirds can fly backwards. Most of the birds can fly. Birds fly with the help of flapping movement of their wings. Birds like kiwi, ostrich and penguin do not fly at all. Birds fly to different types. Different birds have different feet and claws. Most birds build nests to live in. Birds use variety of materials to make their nest. Okay, children? So, this is about birds, types of foods, nest and types of beaks and feathers. Okay, children? Any doubt, children? I think you could have understood the lesson. I'll give you notes also. Okay, children? So, copy the notes in the classwork. Okay, children? Thank you.